In this video, we will continue our discussion on the illuminated PN junction diode and see how the band diagram of an illuminated PN junction diode changes at different operating points. The learning objectives of this lecture are to understand the changes in the band diagram of an illuminated PN junction diode at different operational conditions, and how the built-in voltage changes across the depletion region at different operating conditions. Simulations were used to examine band diagrams of an illuminated PN junction diode based on crystalline silicon operated at different voltage drops at a load. We will use the same parameters in simulations that we used in previous videos. Additionally, we will add a uniform generation rate of 2 times 10 to the power of 20 carriers per cubic centimeter per second. When a load is connected between the electrodes of an illuminated PN junction, we can manipulate the operating point of a solar cell by varying the resistance of the load and corresponding voltage drop at the load. Here you see an IV curve of an illuminated diode. We shall use this figure to show some examples of the operating points. The operating point is indicated by a red circle. We shall describe this curve in more detail in the next video, but for now you can just accept that the PN junction diode under illumination has an IV characteristic as shown in this slide. In the plot we also show power delivered by solar cell that is calculated as the product of the current and voltage. The first operating point is at zero voltage drop at the load. This situation is known as the short circuit condition. This is the band diagram of a PN junction at thermal equilibrium. The Fermi level is a straight and horizontal line across the whole PN junction and represents also the quasi-Fermi levels. Electrons have the same electrochemical energy across the whole PN junction. The figure on the right is a plot of electrostatic potential across the PN junction. Using the previously mentioned input parameters, the potential difference between the P-type and N-type region is 0.9 volts at thermal equilibrium. As you can see, the potential drop is across the depletion region and the potential is positive on the N-type side with respect to the P-type side. Here we see the band diagram of an illuminated PN junction diode at short circuit condition. In other words, the resistance of the external circuit between the electrodes is zero, so that there is no voltage drop at the load. From the band diagram and the graph of the electrostatic potential, we can see that the valence and conduction band edges and the built-in electrostatic potential has not changed with respect to thermal equilibrium. The significant change is in the profile of quasi-Fermi levels. Notice that the energy position of the quasi-Fermi level of electrons in the p-type region is much higher than in the n-type region. This gradient in the quasi-Fermi level determines the amount and direction of current flowing through the diode and external circuit. We increase the resistance of the load such that the voltage drop at the load is 0.1 volt. We can say that we operate the illuminated PN junction at this voltage. The photocurrent delivered into the external circuit by the illuminated diode does not change with respect to the short circuit condition. However, we see in the band diagram that there is a difference in the position of the quasi-Fermi levels at the electrodes attached to the n-type region and the p-type region. This difference is the energy corresponding to the voltage drop at the load. Besides, we see on the right side of the slide the electrostatic potential across the depletion region is lowered by 0.1 volt. This results in an increase in the diffusion current across the depletion region and the recombination current in the quasi-neutral regions that act against the photocurrent. The diffusion and recombination current is the current that flows through the diode in dark and at forward bias voltage of 0.1 volt. Therefore, we call this current diode dark current. When the voltage drop across the load is smaller than the open circuit voltage, the direction of the net current flow is governed by the photocurrent. We can further increase the resistance of the load so that we operate the solar cell at a higher voltage point. When the voltage drop at the load equals to 0.2 volt, we see the difference in the electrochemical potential between the N-type and P-type region is further increased, as indicated by the quasi-Fermi levels. And the potential barrier across the depletion region is decreased by 0.2 volts. Then we keep increasing the load voltage to 0.3 volts. We see the similar trend in the behavior of quasi-Fermi levels and electrostatic potential. The difference between the position of the quasi-Fermi levels in the P-type and N-type regions of the diode is decreasing. These are the plots of band diagram and electrostatic potential for the operating voltage of 0.4 volts. When the voltage drop at the load happens to be the voltage at the maximum power point, the solar cell is operated at the maximum power point. This is the point at which a solar cell delivers the maximum useful power to the external circuit. When the resistance of the load becomes so large that there is barely any current flowing in the circuit, the voltage measured at the load equals to the open circuit voltage, and the solar cell is in the open circuit condition. We can see that there is no difference in the position of quasi-Fermi levels in the P-type and N-type regions. They are horizontal in the entire band diagram of the illuminated PN junction, which indicates no current flow through the diode. The diffusion and recombination current is increased by further lowering the potential difference across the depletion region to the level that it balances the photocurrent. When we want to go beyond the open circuit voltage in the plot and see what happens with the current, we have to apply voltage from an external source, just as we have done it in the case of diode under forward bias condition. If we apply a voltage larger than the open circuit voltage to an illuminated PN junction diode, the potential barrier that acts against the diffusion of majority carriers will be further lowered. The diffusion and recombination current will become larger than the photocurrent, and the PN junction diode will operate like at forward bias conditions. We observe that the slope of the quasi-Fermi levels has changed, and the position of quasi-Fermi levels of electrons has become higher in the N-type with respect to the position in P-type. This indicates that there is a net current flowing through the illuminated diode, but this time the direction is opposite to the photocurrent. We also notice that the depletion region is narrowed down as the potential barrier is reduced. In this video, we discuss the effect of the illumination on a PN junction diode and its band diagram. In the next video, we will go to details of derivation of the illuminated IV curve.